Let's read, let's do all the prayers together and then we can read translation. Kandiya Narsimha Pade Magi Bokka Kana Kandiya Narsimha Pade Magi Bokka Kana Nira Pade Navadvipe Jugala Bhajana Nira Pade Navadvipe Jugala Bhajana Bhaya Bhaya Paya Yanra Darshane Sehari Prasanna Pauyi Bokka Be More Dayakari Bhaya Bhaya Sehari Prasanna Koi Bokabe More Daya Uri Yadyapi Bhishana Murti Dushta Jiva Prati Prahlada Di Krishna Bhakta Jane Bhadrati Yadyapi Bhishana Dushtam Vaprati Adhadi Krishna Bhakta Jane Bhadrasati Kabeva Prasanna Hoye Sakrupa Vachane Kabeva Na Hoye Sakrupa Vachane Nirbhaya Karibe Muda Akinchane Nirbhaya Swachande Baisho He Vatsa Sri Gauranga Dhame Jugala Bhajana Ho Rati Ho Name Swachande Shohaye Dhame Jugala Bhajana Ho Mama Bhakta Krupa Bale Vigna Jabe Dura Mama Bhakta Krupa Bale Jabedura Shuddha Chite Bhajo Radha Krishna Rasa Pura Ebolika Be Mora Mastaka Upara Sviya Sri Charana Harshe Dhari Be Ishvara Eboli Be Mora Mastaka Upara Amani jugala prema satvika vikare Amani jugala prema vikare Dharaya lutibo ami Sri Narsimha dware Naya Nidhi Narsimbang. So, who can read the second? We read the first one. Go up, still go up. Yeah, that's the one.
When will this Lord Hari, whose terrible form strikes fear into fear itself, ever become pleased and show me his mercy?
Even though Lord Narsimha is terrifying toward the sinful souls, he offers great auspiciousness unto the devotees of Lord Krishna, headed by Prahlad Maharaja. When will he be pleased to speak words of compassion unto me, a worthless fool, and thereby make me fearless?
He will say, dear child, sit down freely and live happily here in Sri Gauranga Dhamma. May you nicely worship the divine couple and may you develop loving attachment for their holy names. By the mercy of my devotees, all obstacles are cast far away. With the purified heart, just perform the worship of Radha and Krishna. Such worship overflows with sweet nectar.
Saying this, will that Lord delightedly place his own divine lotus feet upon my head? I will experience sublime love for the divine couple Radha Krishna and undergo the ecstatic transformations called Satvika. Falling on the ground, I will roll about at the door of Sri Narsimha's temple.
So if you see the first translation, Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, within my sinful heart, the six enemies headed by lust perpetually reside, as well as duplicity, the desire for fame, plus sheer cunning. at the lotus feet of Lord Narasimha, I hope that he will mercifully purify my heart and give me the desire to serve Lord Krishna. So here you see Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he is putting in the shoes of a conditioned soul how one's sinful heart is perpetually the residence of the six sinful qualities headed by lust, as well as duplicity, desire for fame, sheer cunning. So we should all pray to the lotus feet of Narasimhadev that he will mercifully purify our hearts and give us the desire to serve Lord Krishna. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur's prayer is to actually serve Radha Krishna. And actually, if you see towards the end, Narasimhadeva is saying, my dear child, sit down freely. Live happily here in Gauranga Dhamma. May you nicely worship the divine couple. So this is, who is saying this? Narasimhadeva is saying. Lord Narasimha, every day he attends Mangalarti of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, one time he was in Navadvip, and so he was trying to find the birthplace, establish the birthplace of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because that was being up our hearts. We should open up what all impurities are there in our hearts. Even Prahlad Maharaj, even though he was a Mahabhagavat, he was saying, when all these demigods could not offer prayers, they were so terrified looking at Lord Narasimha. For a moment, they couldn't realize that the Lord himself came. And they pushed Prahlad Maharaj in front. So the Lord will be pacified. He came for you only, so you go. Even Lakshmi Devi could not pacify him. So Prahlad Maharaj, he said, I am born in sinful species. Sattvaikatana gatayo vachasam prabahai. And sarve hi eme tava vidhikaras tava sattva dhamno brahmadayo vayam ivesha na chodvijanta. These are all great qualities these people have, the great demigods. And whereas I am born in a sinful species, but these people are pushing me to offer you the prayers, you will accept irrespective of any material condition. Just like Bhaktya Tutosha Bhagavan Gajayutha Paya. Even an animal like Gajendra was able to satisfy you by prayers which are free from kalmasha. So Lord Narasimha is the protector of all the conditioned souls, Dina Bandhu, and we should completely take shelter of his lotus feet on this day. If you scroll down, in Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela, there are some nice prayers. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu visits some pilgrimage places. This happens in Madhya Leela 8th chapter. Purvarite Prabhu Age Gamana Karila Jiyada Narasimha Kshetre Kata Dine Gela. According to his previous program, Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went forward on his tour and after some days arrived at the place of pilgrimage known as Jiyada Narasimha. Who can say where is this place? You saw the purport? How many of you went there? Hari Bol. Is it Simhachalam? Yeah. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu visited that place. Purport. The Jiyada Narasimha temple is situated on the top of a hill about 5 miles away from Visakhapatnam. There is a railway station on the South Indian Railway known as Simhachala. The temple known as Simhachala is the best temple in the vicinity of Visakhapatnam. Jai. This temple is very affluent and is a typical example of the architecture of the area. In one stone tablet, it is mentioned that formerly a queen covered the deity with gold plate. This is mentioned in the Visakhapatnam Gazetteer. About the temple, there are residential quarters for the priests and devotees. Indeed, at the present moment, there are many residential quarters to accommodate visiting devotees. The original deity is situated within the depths of the temple, but there is another deity, a duplicate known as the Vijayamurti. This smaller deity can be moved from the temple and taken on public processions. Priests who generally belong to the Ramanuja Sampradaya are in charge of the deity worship.
Narsimha dekhiya kaila dandavat pranati prema veshe kaila bahu nrutya gita stuti.
After seeing the deity of Lord Narsimha in the temple, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu offered his respectful obeisances by falling flat. Then, in ecstatic love, he performed various dances, chanted and offered prayers.
Sri Narsimha Jai Narsimha Jai Jai Narsimha Prahladesha Jaya Padma Mukha Padma Bhringa.
So this is the prayer offered by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. All glories to Narsimhadeva, all glories to Narsimhadeva, who is the Lord of Prahlad Maharaj and like a honeybee is always engaged in beholding the lotus-like face of the Goddess of Fortune. Purport. The Goddess of Fortune is always embraced by Lord Narsimhadeva. This is mentioned in the commentary on Srimad Bhagavatam, written by the great commentator Srila Sridhara Swami. The following verse was composed by Sridhara Swami in his commentary on Srimad Bhagavatam 10.87.1.
Vagisha yasya vadane lakshmir yasya cha vakshasi yasyaste hridaye samvit tam narsimham aham bhaje.
Lord Narsimhadeva is always assisted by Saraswati, the goddess of learning, and he is always embracing to his chest the goddess of fortune. The Lord is always complete in knowledge within himself. Let us offer obeisances unto Narsimhadeva. Similarly, in his commentary on the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam 1.1.1, Sridhara Swami describes Lord Narsimhadeva in this way.
Prahlada hridayahladam bhakta vidya vidaranam charadindu ruchim vande parindra vadanam harim.
Let me offer my obeisances unto Lord Narsimhadeva, who is always enlightening Prahlad Maharaj within his heart and who always kills the nations that attacks the devotees. His mercy is distributed like moonshine and his face is like that of a lion. Let me offer my obeisances unto him again and again. Text 6.
Ugropi anugra evayam svabhaktanam nrikeshari Keshariva Swapotanam Anyesham Ugravikramaha.
It's a beautiful verse. Although very ferocious, Ugro api Anugra evayam Swabhaktanam Nrukeshari. Even though Lord Narsimha is Ugra, Ugraha api, but to his own cubs, just like a lioness is very kind to her cubs, he is very kind to his devotees. Although he is very ferocious to non-devotees, like Hiranyakashipu. Lord Narsimhadeva is very, very soft and kind to devotees like Prahlad Maharaj. This verse was composed by Sridhara Swami in his commentary on Srimad Bhagavatam 7.9.1. So you should learn one verse that you should offer to Narsimhadeva whenever you see Narsimhadeva in the temple. Either this one or any simple one, Vagisha Yasya Vadane that we read, or Sri Narsimha Jaya Narsimha Jaya Jaya Narsimha, Prahladesha Jaya Padma, Mukha Padma Bhringa. It will be good to offer some prayer to the Lord when we see him, or simply Hare Krishna also will do. So 7th.
Eimata Nana Shloka Padi Stuti Kaila Narsimha Sevaka Mala Prasada Ani Dila.
In this way, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recited different verses from the Shastra. The priest of Lord Narasimhadeva then brought garlands and the remnants of the Lord's food and offered them to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was expert in picking up different verses appropriate from the scriptures and would offer to the Lord wherever he visited. Different temples, different incarnations of the Lord, he would offer appropriate prayers. So this is another nice verse from Srimad Bhagavatam 5.18.8, Lord Narasimha.
Om Namo Bhagavate Narasimhaya Namaste Jaste Jase Aviravirbhava Vajranakha Vajradamstra Karmashayan Randhaya Randhaya Tamo Grasa Grasa Om Swaha Abhayam Abhayam Atmani Bhuyishtha Om Shraum.
I offer my respectful obeisances unto Lord Narasimhadeva, the source of all power. O my Lord, who possesses nails and teeth just like thunderbolts, kindly vanquish our demon-like desires for fruitive activity in this material world. Please appear in our hearts and drive away our ignorance, so that by your mercy we may become fearless in the struggle for existence in this material world. It's a very important prayer. The Lord possesses nails and teeth just like thunderbolts. Thunderbolt, Indra uses to pulverize these big mountains. So our mountainous sins can be pulverized by the thunderbolts of nails of Lord Narasimha. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, the author compares Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to a lion. Kalmashadviradanashe yanhara hunkare Chaitanya simhera navadvipe avatar Simhadgriva simhavirya simhera hunkara Sei simhavasuk jivera hrudayakandare Kalmashadviradanashe yanhara hunkare. So it means Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is like a lion. He has the neck of a lion, simhagriva, simhavirya. He has the prowess of a lion. Simhera hunkara, his sankirtan is like a lion's roaring. And Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is saying, Sei simha vasuk jivera hrudaya kandare. Let that lion stay in the hearts, jivera hrudaya kandare. And kalmashadvirada. The kalmasha is being compared to like, what is it being compared to like? The lion, what does it attack? Or who runs away by looking at the lion? And the kalmasha can be huge, like a elephant. Kalmasha dvirada means the kalmasha in our hearts are like elephants. That's why it says elephantine vices. Very heavy. It's very hard. We sometimes use the word the elephant in the room. So very hard to get away. So by praying to the Lord, who is like a lion, he can get rid of our elephantine vices. So in the whole Prahlad story, Prahlad Maharaj was just a small boy. He was completely helpless from a material perspective. Either physical strength or his so-called friend circle, he was isolated from meeting his friends, and his father had only one mission, to kill him. But Prahlad Maharaj prevailed over everything because of the mercy of Lord Narasimha. Wherever he was attacked, the Lord was protecting him. So if our goal is devotion, if we sincerely, like Prahlad Maharaj, sincerely want to progress in devotion, the Lord will protect. Whatever it may be, whatever obstacle it may be, physical, mental, any obstacle that it comes in the path of devotion, the Lord will protect all of us. And we should have confidence. Just like Prahlad Maharaj was having confidence on Lord, and Lord was protecting. So everyone can be protected. There are many lessons one can learn from Narasimhadeva's pastime. How he made the words of a pure devotee true, like Brahma's words. Even though he gave a very difficult boon, tricky boon, but he still came in a way that still satisfied the words of a pure devotee. So when Prabhupada says something, it has to happen. So when we remain loyal to Prabhupada's words, Narasimhadeva has to come and protect. So he is bound by the words of his pure devotee. Kaunteya pratijanihi name bhaktaha pranasyati. What is the full verse? Kshipram bhavati dharmatma shashvat chantim nigachati kaunteya pratijanihi name bhaktaha pranasyati. So a devotee always feels confident, whereas a demon feels the wrath of Narasimha. Like how Hiranyakashipu felt the wrath. A non-believer always feels the wrath of God, the fierce form of God. Mrityuhu sarvaharas chaham. Whereas for a devotee, what is being said here? Ugropi anugra evayam. The cub will go and jump on the lion. Even though the lion is ferocious to different animals, different living entities. But to its own cub, the lion is very kind. That's why when Prahlad Maharaj went forward, Narasimhadeva actually put his hand around Prahlad Maharaj. Like he put his hand on his head. How we put our hands on our heads of our children with love and affection. So Prahlad Maharaj was completely pacified by the words of Narasimhadeva was completely pacified by the words of Prahlad Maharaj. Not by anyone else. He came just for saving Prahlad Maharaj. Sometimes people ask the question, how come Narasimhadeva came from a pillar? What is the special significance? Because a devotee sees everywhere Krishna. And the example I gave was, there was one time a driver driving a big truck, and he parked in a place. It was a huge truck. And this child had this marker, and he was going behind this truck and is drawing all kinds of things in the back of the truck. And then he went away. And then as soon as the child went away, the truck driver immediately jumped down from his driver's seat, went running after the child and brought him and brought his father also and showed him, see what your child did. And then the father had to plead him and pay some money to get rid of the mischievous deed of this child. And so what I was trying to say is, this truck driver, even though it's a big semi-truck, huge truck, 20, 30 feet, but he could understand what is happening at the back of the truck by remaining seated in the front of the truck. So the Lord's consciousness is spread in this entire universe, even though he is situated in Goloka Vrindavan. Maya tatam idam sarvam jagat avyakta murtina matsthani sarva bhutani nachaham teshvavasthitah. By me, maya tatam, tatam means pervaded, maya tatam idam sarvam, by my unmanifested form, I am cognizant of this entire material manifestation. Maya tatam idam sarvam jagat avyakta murtina. Why avyakta murtina? Why unmanifested form? Because when we see matter, we see only matter. We don't see the spirit behind matter. When I see you, I see your body. I don't see the spirit soul in the body. So as long as we remain in the material world, we cannot see the Lord's manifest form. He is unmanifest in this material world. But he is spread everywhere by his energy. He can conceive. Just like the big truck driver, he was able to conceive everything happening in his truck. Sometimes when we drive our vehicle, a slight touch behind also we can feel. Slight touch. That means we are aware of the whole vehicle even though we are sitting in one place. And so just like this truck driver came out of the truck, whenever there is a need, whenever something happens in some part of the creation, what is the wonder of Narasimhadeva coming out of pillar? It is part of his creation. The truck driver came when something came, something happened in his truck. So Lord Narasimha also came from the pillar. So the Lord can come. For the truck driver, the only front door is the door. For the Lord, he can make any place he has his door. Anywhere he can come out if he feels the need to protect his devotee. So the Lord's love for his devotee is beyond material consideration. People who blame Krishna, who deride Krishna by pointing out his activities with gopis, don't consider how Krishna, whether he enacts his pastimes with gopis or he embraces Prahlad Maharaj in the form of Narasimhadev, or he shows loving affection to Hanuman in the form of Lord Rama, or he shows loving affection to Lakshmi Devi in the form of Narayana, or to the cowherd boys, or to Vaikunthavasis as Vishnu. They are all one and the same. One should not differentiate the Lord's pastime. Nobody blinks an eye, Narasimhadeva embracing Prahlad Maharaj. Why should one feel anything different when Krishna embraces gopis? It is not enacted on material platform. It is enacted on spiritual platform. That is why in Bhagavatam you see, it is gradually built up. First few cantos explain about the material energy of the Lord. And then slowly all these incarnations come. His third, fourth cantos, fifth cantos, his avataras as Vishnu, Narayana. Then gradually, seventh canto about Narasimhadeva, and ninth canto mentions Lord Rama, and then finally Krishna. Why? Sukadeva Goswami is preparing the mindset of everyone. Don't mistake Krishna to be ordinary. He's gradually building up and bringing us to the platform of Krishna. So we should understand that all the exchanges of love between the Lord and devotees are on transcendental platform. So I'll stop here. Any other questions? Anyone wants to share anything on Narasimha Chaturdasi? Any prayers we want to share? Please, Mataji.
In Prabhupada's purport, in line with what you just said, Prabhu. So what I really liked is Prabhupada mentions when Narasimhadev comes out of the pillar, it's not because Hiranyakashipu wanted to see him there. It's because Prahlada believed and told the whole world, and he told Hiranyakashipu that he's everywhere, he's there everywhere. So at that time, it seems Narasimhadev, in that Narasimha avatara, he was everywhere. He was in the whole universe. He was pervaded as in that avatara, because he was like, I don't know where Prahlada will call me from. So he was just ready to make his devotee's word come true. Prabhupada's purport was beautiful there. It was like, just to make it believe, he was just waiting in every object of the whole universe. Hare Krishna.
Your realizations, your prayers, good chance.
I just wanted to bring up the pastime of Chand Kazi. So when Chand Kazi obstructs the Sankirtana movement, that time, I mean, Chand Kazi realizes when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes, he says that he discloses to him, saying that how that night when he broke the dole, the mridanga and everything, and he disturbed and he came back. So there was a lion on his chest tearing apart and giving him a warning. So wherever Sankirtana movement and Srila Prabhupada's mission is going, if it is being obstructed, Narasimha Deva is always there to protect that movement and the mission of Srila Prabhupada. So it always gives me a lot of confidence.
Prabhu, in one of the temples, ISKCON temples, I saw that they put Lord Ganesh deity outside the main altar. And they say that he is the one who actually helps us to progress in the path of devotion. So is that true? Because actually today I came to know that Narasimha Deva is worshipped because so that we can worship Radha Krishna.
Just based on that, there was a shloka in Brahma Samhita where it is said that Lord Ganesha always keeps the lotus feet of Lord Narasimha on his tusks, and that's how he gets his power to be Vighna Vinashan.
Yeah, that's true. Actually, nectar of devotion, worship of Ganesha is mentioned. But the devotees saw that in nectar of devotion during Prabhupada's days. And they said, Prabhupada, it's mentioned like this in nectar of devotion. Can we start worshipping Ganesha so we can, get a lot of, Lakshmi, and our movement will flourish. So Prabhupada said, it's not needed. Our vignas are eradicated by six Goswamis. What is that line? Hariharaya Namaha. Vigna Nasha Hoy. The one line Narottam Das Thakur sings about the six Goswamis. So our vignas are removed by six Goswamis. And Prabhupada said, still, if you want to install Ganesha and worship him, you should promise me that every month you should send me $100,000. Then I will allow you to worship. Effectively ruling out. Of course, we don't have anything against Ganesha. He's a great devotee of the Lord. Yat pada pallava yugam vinidhaya kumbha dvandve pranama samaye sagana adhiraja. So he gets the power of removing obstacles by Narasimha Dev, who is the ultimate remover of obstacles for us. But Prabhupada didn't establish that standard. Maybe some temple, see, we cannot comment on a decision taken by some temple by, we have to understand what is involved before passing a comment. There may be a special circumstance. So, but in general, Prabhupada did not allow, we can probably respect by placing a picture for that particular day, but still, it has to be properly discussed, understood, and then only done. But in general, no. He installed Vigneshwara, Ganesha. Yeah, I'm hearing for the first time. Okay. So any final comments? Sridhar wants to speak.
Hare Krishna. So I vaguely remember this memory, but it was like very heart-touching for me when I was in my initial days trying to understand Krishna consciousness. So this is about book distribution. So one of a devotee was sharing that they were planning to go to a place for book distribution where like there were people who were like kind of this gundas. They were like trying to making a plan to attack those devotees when they're going to come for book distribution. So the devotees made prayers and they prayed to Narasimhadev, and somehow because devotees always wanted to give mercy to everyone, they knew that those people were there who want to create some trouble to them. And these devotees, they were walking towards that place, and those violent people, they were watching them, and all of a sudden they started running away after seeing these devotees. So this devotee is like doesn't understand like why are they just running away, and later he comes to know that when the devotee was coming along with them, a ferocious lion was also coming with them. So it was Narasimhadev himself who was giving that darshan to those violent people that I am always there like to protect them. So even in service also, if we are so much sincere, unknowingly like we feel like so many benefits we are getting, but the Lord is kind of giving that benediction. So Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. You know, just wanted to share, I was reading Prabhupada Leelamrita long back, and I, like many devotees were, when actually this Narasimha prayers has been started by Srila Prabhupada, I mean, usually, initially when we started, we didn't had Narasimha prayers, not only in our temple, in everywhere. So in 1967, Prabhupada wasn't feeling well, and then he was getting very much worried that his mission will be stopped, and then how can he, and then that is the time, first time he dictated the prayers actually. In even though he was sick, he dictated the prayers, and when Mataji or Prabhu, they wrote down these Narasimha prayers, and then he asked them to make a copy. At that time only we had centers in New York and San Francisco. So he sent everybody, I mean one more copy was sent to San Francisco, and everybody started praying to Lord Narasimhadeva for the wellness of Srila Prabhupada, and for the, actually for the movement, so that the movement should not be hindered and it should be progressed. So after that, I mean after Prabhupada was well, and then he recuperated from whatever it was, and he started. But still he said we should continue this Narasimha prayers, so that Narasimhadeva will always protect our Krishna consciousness movement from all the anardas and so many things going on. So every time, I mean, you should continue these prayers throughout. So, I mean, still, I mean, many people ask, why you sing only Narasimha? There are so many avatars of Krishna. Why you sing only Narasimha prayers in your temple, in ISKCON temple? So a lot of people get those questions. But Prabhupada said, Narasimhadeva is the one who can protect us from obstacles. So we should keep reciting those prayers.
Okay, going. Vrindaraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Prahlad Narasimhadev ki jai, Narasimhadev Chaturdasi Mahotsav ki jai, Nithai Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari Bol.